Okay, hear that, folks. Just a little bit worried about my connection. Right before I actually flipped the camera over there, it started to act up. Looked all right since, so I think it'll be okay. Early start, it's 4:36 a.m. right now, which isn't that unusual for me getting up. It's just that normally I work at this time rather than stream. Not going to be wearing headphones today because I I'm home alone with the kids. So cool. The thing with this is that I would have had no idea that this was a nebula because you can't really see it. So as far as bookmarks go, that's the next one that's selected. Where is it? Okay, so that's where I am right now, is number four. Number five. Okay. Number five is the one I want to head to, but I'm kind of tempted to go to this nebula first. If we can see what any interesting stars that are in it. Kind of hoping that there would be okay, so there's a neutron star in the middle of the nebula. 470 light years away. Okay. We've been here. I'm going to remove the before that though. So I know that I've actually been there. And then I still have these two to visit before I head towards Sagittarius A. How many jumps is this going to be? We have one to go, get to a neutron star, and then three jumps to get to another neutron star. So we're going to be there really quickly. That's great. Or was there anything else that I wanted to see in this system? Could probably go towards the black hole. Or one of the black holes. Let's see if I can get a good screenshot there. The reason why I'm going to the bottom left of the nebula is because I want to get that, or the bottom left of the black hole is because I want to get the black hole between me and that nebula. If you look really closely at the black hole, which is selected at the top right, you can kind of see stars going around it. That's the lensing effect. Of the galaxy. There's actually a couple of lensing effects going on right here. I think that's another black hole. Okay, so if you look at the nebula right now, you can definitely see what the black hole is doing to it. You can get to black holes now. It used to be a fairly big kind of exclusion zone around them. Okay, so now you're starting to see a point. Oops, here we go. Starting to see a point in the middle now where light actually can't get around, like it's not lensing around the black hole. And you can start to see the lensing kind of wider out. Really don't know how close I can get, but it's been a long time since I've been near one. Just going to see what this looks like from Mars. Keep going closer for a minute. Wonder if it's 1 megameter. Hi, not sure how to pronounce your name. I'll say Bang. How are you? Obviously, lots of lensing going on. And you know what? There. Having the nebula behind adds a really cool effect. No, I'm not on Distant Worlds 2. I'm heading to Beagle Point, and I have a lot of the points of interest, or I had a lot of the points of interest bookmarked that I wanted to go see. So, like, this is the system I'm in is called Collection of Wonders, and it was one of the points of interest that was on one of their maps. Because I haven't explored or really played Elite since 2016, and I figured those guys would know a lot of the places to visit that I hadn't been to. So these bookmarks here are places that I went to 2016 and before here. And then I added a few through here from Distant Worlds 2. So I'm basically going to work my way up towards Sagittarius A. And then these bookmarks are my bookmarks that I found on the forums again of how to get to Beagle Point safely with my jump range. But I may not use these three. I'm thinking I may actually kind of try to go my own way a little bit out towards one of these arms here, and then actually follow it around and then go up to Beagle Point there. Not sure yet. I just like I've already found that there's a lot of new stuff to me in the nebulas, and obviously I can see a few that are kind of similar heights. That I could use to get out towards the arm, and then a lot of smaller ones obviously if you zoom in, but I should be able to find enough to kind of entertain me to get out that way and then out towards Beagle Point. So yeah, I mean, if you've been following Distant Worlds 2, you may have seen this system with people, but obviously it's all new to me. Why I'm here. Oh, my ship is warm. 54%. toasty. I'm also creating basically YouTube videos of my journey, and that's why every so often, like this, I'll remove the cockpit and just basically look at it from the external camera view so that I can get kind of footage that I can use in a video. Yeah, the asteroid bases are new to me. They didn't exist back when I played the game before. I'll be smooth with my rotation here. So yeah, like right at the beginning of this journey, that was the first time that I was ever in one of the asteroid bases. Yeah, like all I need for the YouTube video is like 15 seconds or so of whatever shot I'm trying to get, pretty much. And then some of it works better than others. And maybe I can do that smoothly, let's see. Have an interesting look for the nebula. Yeah, back when I explored the majority of the bookmarks that I have, you had the kind of populated bubble of systems, and there was nothing outside of that. So if you screwed up at the like anywhere in the galaxy, you know, that was it. You just kind of lost everything. It's actually quite nice though. Like, I'm not one of those like a purist, I guess, which Elite Dangerous unfortunately has a lot of those people that think the game should be just really difficult no matter what. I don't think it really helps it that much. Kind of look like I just bounced off the black hole there, weirdly. body exclusion zone hit, so I actually did bounce off it. Right. So, I'm going to jump out of here now. Head on my way.
Frameshift drive charging.
Probably going to overheat on my way out. That's not too bad. I'm in a Cobra Mark III. No heat sinks. I've actually pretty much stuck with an exploration fitting that I would have used back when I used to play, so there definitely could be mistakes that I've made with my fitting. If you don't know what that was a neutron star, and it has these jets that fly out of opposite ends of it and that kind of loop around. Depending on how fast the star is spinning is how cone-like those things will look. And if you fly through the cones, then basically it supercharges your FSD. And as you can see, the next system in front of me is 134 light years away. And I can jump it, or jump to that, because I just supercharged with that neutron star. I usually try to do that. The success rate is totally down to me, pretty much. That whole, the FSS and stuff like that is all new to me on this trip as well. That didn't exist the last time I explored. Something really close to the star there. Maybe not. Flying in a bit of a weird direction for this next jump. But this is probably a neutron star. Yeah, okay. So it's taking me away from where I actually want to go to get me to a neutron star to jump there faster. I think I have that, the link, or I have like an image that's saved somewhere on my computer that when I got back into the game and if I tried to find an updated version of, I found one on Reddit, I think. That basically advised kind of what to scan and what not to scan now. That's all kind of different too. What I think is really cool about the nebulas and stuff now, though, is that you'll have like these life forms and like really weird things that also didn't exist the last time I played that are all in there. And I'm trying not to spoil that too much for myself. I kind of like the Distant Worlds 2 stuff, I knew that there was certain places to go, so I just kind of bookmarked them, and then I didn't research a whole lot into what I was going to see at those points. So I've managed to be kind of pleasantly surprised with things. But then obviously once I get past Sagittarius A and I'm heading my own way, then everything I find will be, you know, possibly something that nobody else has seen in whatever system I actually find it in. Yeah, that might be the same image that I have, if it's one that you saved from somewhere. Speaking of the official forums, I actually tried to log in yesterday, and they've updated the forums, so I actually can't log in, so I'm going to have to contact them and probably annoyingly ask them to fix my login. It's associated with an email that I have on a second account that isn't the email that I used for the forums, and yeah, it doesn't like that very much. With the update that they've just done on the forums. Engineering is about the time when I stopped playing. when they first of all introduced engineers, it was an incredibly hard grind. I liked the idea of it, but doing it was just so convoluted and annoying. And it's weird. It's not like the whole rest of the game didn't have these kind of loops that you had, or hoops that you had to jump through. But it just felt really annoying with the engineers. So when the engineers came out, I basically stopped playing the gameplay that I did normally, which was things like sort of bounty hunting. And instead I went exploring because I was kind of bored of the game as it was. And that's the nice thing about Elite, really, is that you can go and have a whole new gameplay experience within the same game. And I was kind of bored of the old game, which was doing bounty hunting and everything. And I didn't want to do the engineer stuff, so I kind of avoided it by playing a whole new game, which was the exploring. When I got done with that exploration run, I just didn't have any real interest in kind of going back to the gameplay that was still there. And at that point, they had actually made engineers a lot better, but I just wasn't into it at that point. I think I did engineer the frame shift drive on this Cobra before I left a little bit. But the thing about exploration that I kind of liked was actually seeing the stuff. So I didn't want to have like a massive jump range that would bypass too many systems, if that makes any sense. I do have a second account. I've actually never used it. The only thing I've actually used it for was making videos for my YouTube channel, where I wanted to have the kind of voice distortion that they have over their player comms. So basically because I have a separate streaming PC that streams, and then I play on my gaming PC that's basically piped into the streaming PC. I ran Elite on the streaming PC and basically talked to myself on the gaming PC and then captured the gaming PC's audio so that I could distort my audio a little bit. Bit weird. Where is the orbital plane? Oh, biological. I'm gonna go see what that biological signature is. Scanning. Silicate magma. 22 geological sites and 10 biological sites. Humble Bundle's a great site for stuff that like you normally can't get like brand new kind of AAA games, but there's a lot of really, really, really good games that have been out a little while. And I'll tend to buy it there over waiting for like a Steam sale or whatever. Someone's actually mapped this one, but they didn't map the other ones for some reason. A lot of biological science in this system. This is the primary reason why I like to get close to the nebulas. It does seem like there's more to see. Nebulas. Oh, it's a water world. I actually thought it was going to be an ammonia world, but it's a water world. So there's one behind the star there. Right, let's go see what those biological signatures were. Yeah, that's like I've had to learn all this. I actually was watching a streamer called I think his username is Malik VR because he always plays with a VR headset. And I asked him, you know, if when I first of all kind of was thinking about getting back into Elite, asked him to kind of run through things a little bit. And one of the biggest tips that he gave me was to look at that top right when you're in the FSS to kind of see whether, like, that was where he said you would see whether there was something that you wanted to explore a little bit more. And it's totally true. Like if there's even like ruins from like a human habitation, which I have actually found on this trip. I found an old human base. You'll actually see those up at the top right. It'll say human instead of biological. So now, with those two biological signs, the only annoying thing about these target things is that when I get closer to this planet, that's going to jump somewhere else. I feel like they have their maps kind of misaligned a little bit. See it jumping around a little bit, but it actually hasn't done it as much as I've seen it in the past. Okay, so it looks like it's maybe lots of little cone-shaped things. I've actually found something similar to these before. These are the same thing that I've actually seen somewhere else. So there's no way to see on here. It's annoying. Oh, for God's sake.
Frameshift drive charging.
So I really have to be in this mode. Oh no. Try and find that other one. There it is.
System scan complete.
I'll land on that one anyway. So that's a gap in my knowledge, is which of the ones that I previously scanned have the biological signature on them. And I've just locked a target in the system map, and now there's nothing in this screen telling me where that was. I did look on there, but I probably was selecting one of the planets that I can't actually land on, like you were saying. Yeah, there's nothing there that tells me about biological. You can see that there's geological sites on there because it's here. Nowhere on here does it say what I could see in the FSS. Hmm. feel like that's a bit of a gap in the information that you're provided with. Now I can go, because I know it's directly in front of me. Okay, so it can't be that one. So I think the reason why he mapped these is because obviously there was a lot of signatures. I think it's EC 1 and 2. I'll find out when I get there. I ordered new glasses because these ones are actually scratched from when I'm driving, putting on like clip-on sunglasses, and I've scratched like right through where I look. And when I'm playing a game or anything, it's really annoying for my vision. I'm so looking forward to getting those new glasses. Of course, we still haven't got to the nebula that I was actually going to yet. Right by the side of it, though. This one. This is where I'm heading. Right, okay. There we go. So it's been mapped by someone else, but I want to see what the biological sites actually are. Okay, so you've searched on the forums. Only in the FSS view can you see the sites, not in the map view. That's why people use ED Discovery, because that shows them. Okay. Thank you. ED Discovery is something I've never used. There's been a lot of like tools and things for the game that I've never used. Like I said earlier, it's not because I'm like a purist or anything. Uh-oh. As soon as I cleared that star, my speed just suddenly increased, and I wasn't ready for it. I think Inara was just getting going the last time I played. So the nearest one is that one, which means it should be on this side of the planet, nearest. If I ever say anything, like if you're in the chat and I ever say anything that's really obvious, it's because I'm adding basically commentary. So if someone watches the VOD of the stream and doesn't know something, it basically explains it to them. So, I'm not trying to be, what's the word? Can't think of the word. Just a random geological. After this, I'm going to go see what one of the biological signs is. Covered in shadow. See smoke, and I can see residue. Sulfur dioxide fumarole. Okay. night vision is new as well. That wasn't in. Whoops. That wasn't in before. You basically just had to crash into things like that before. And apparently I still do.
Landing gear deployed.
Oh, there's one that's active. Yeah, it's very hard to see these in these shaded areas. I hate that it limits you to 250 meters. And, like, you can zoom in, but kind of reduces the actually quite a nice view. So annoying how the camera does that. No, I really don't like any of those camera views. Okay, so biological 197. I do have an SRV, yeah. It's just, with this being so much in shadow, I just literally don't think that there's going to be anywhere to really see it very well. Yeah. Fly into space and then come back. Why is it changed into a dotted line? Like it's suddenly on the other side of the planet. This is definitely something I've never seen before. Oops, wrong one. A Punisium brain tree. Here I can land, maybe here.
Landing gear deployed.
A little bit of a slope, maybe. How cool is that? Usually they have interesting sounds, so I'm just going to put my headphones on to hear it. That kind of bin that you hear every so often is probably the plant sound that they've added. I'm not playing with the headphones on because my wife is out of town, so I have to listen for the kids. I unfortunately don't have all of the camera controls mapped, which is why you see me twirling every so often. That way, that way. Grab a few seconds of footage from here, and I'll take the SRV out. Just to explain, I have two capture cards. So I stream using one as a source, and then I record from the other one. So whatever resolution I stream at the same time I'm recording 1080p 60 frames a second from the second card. It may be possible to kind of harvest something from these plants. Oh, they're actually quite big, aren't they? That's actually way bigger than I thought it was. Way bigger than I thought it was. there. And see what happens with growth. The only weapon of any kind that I actually have is in the turret here. Gives a nickel. Is that it? Okay, so looks like there's a few different kinds of things. The seed pod, what does that give? It's just like attached to the side of the tree. And it seems kind of invincible. Wonder if it's because I'm shooting through the tree. These are pretty kind of basic materials. So I think that one. This one's bright yellow. Ruthenium. I think that is used jumping. I don't know if I can knock it down from the tree. Probably not. So I think ruthenium is used FSD injection or no? No, it's not. Okay. What it was.
ship. Way up there.
Okay, well, that is new to me. I mean, it was interesting. There was like the plant and everything, but the materials that came from it, the only one that I'm curious what it is, was ruthenium. The other ones were very basic materials. But ruthenium isn't used for energy extraction, which I wasn't really interested in. The game is entertaining me for now by basically having put little plants on the surface. So I guess they do their job pretty much.
Landing gear retracted.
So this was a neutron star, and it's inside the nebula.
Frameshift drive charging.
So, nothing really in this system. I'm gonna try and find another star though that might be interesting and see if I can find any more life or that's interesting. Within this nebula, you have two different sector names. Try this one completely randomly.
Charging.
thing's not telling me. I have like a program that populates the thing on the screen that says the most recent follower, and it still hasn't updated on the screen with the person who followed at the end of my last stream. So it's difficult to trust that it's actually updating for this stream either. What have we got here? Water geysers. Five geological sites. I'm pretty sure that will be all water geysers. Oh, it worked for you. Thank you. Thanks for the follow. It's just really weird how it kind of... It's like it skips people who follow... Oh really? It's like it skips people who follow when I'm not streaming, which to me doesn't really seem terribly useful. So do the windscreens actually get dirty now? Like I've seen a few videos of people driving their SRVs over them and getting kind of pushed into space by the water. It's definitely an active system. That's interesting that you say that your windscreen gets dirty. On this trip, I honestly can't say that I've really noticed that. I wonder if it's something that they haven't put in for certain ships or something weird like that. Well, I think this is actually the center of the nebula, pretty much. That's where the label is. So based on that completely random fact. I'm gonna go to that system.
Frameshift drive charging.
Into the system before.
Frameshift drive charging.
Now that you've said it, I'll definitely kind of watch for it. 33 bodies. Around the gas giants in this system. I'm not seeing that other gas giant. I wonder if it's off by itself somewhere. Right, well, let's scan the moons. Moons here, but the ones that don't have any locations should be pretty quick. Again.
Fuel scooping complete.
Okay, thank you very much for hanging out. Thank you for chatting too. It makes the stream a lot more fun. And thanks for the follow too. so weird. There's a gas giant and moons in some random location. That I'm having trouble finding. That must be it.
System scan complete.
That's kind of, well, not really disappointing, but hoped for more, what I'll say. How far away? This is where I'm heading next. It looks like we should be able to get there with a few neutron star jumps. 32 is not that bad.
Frameshift drive charging. Charging. Frameshift drive charging. engaged.
Oh, this is an interesting system. Gas giant with water-based life. Something there. An icy body with rings. Surface features to persuade me to go land. Just trying to look and see what time the Formula One qualifying is today. Thank you. probably a gas giant or something. No. A high metal content world.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Upstairs, so it's looking good that I should be able to get to where I'm going or to the bookmark before the end of the stream. Right, kind of between water worlds and gas worlds and gas giant, so see what it gives us. I quite like to scan the bulk clusters because it gets them out of the way and it normally selects them all for you. You don't have to scan every single asteroid belt. Buster, not belt. Weird. There we go. So a gas giant with water-based life, which is why it was showing. No? Never mind. What I was going to say there was complete crap. Okay, so it looks like there's a location on this one. Iron magma. Based on what I've seen before, iron magma isn't that interesting to go look at. So is this a gas giant or a water world? A water giant? I've never heard of that before. Joysticks drifting a little bit, which is getting annoying. So where is this gas giant? Says about that water giant. Never heard something called a water giant. Is that it? Water giant. So worlds like this have a large atmosphere made mainly of water vapor. It most likely formed when a large icy body warmed up enough to evaporate a large amount of its surface ice. This would in turn trigger a runaway greenhouse effect, leading to a very thick atmosphere made of the evaporated ices. Atmosphere type water. I don't know, like I never saw, like I saw ones like this, a gas giant with water-based life. But I never saw something called a water giant. 98.4% water. 0.5% ammonia, 0.5% methane. Okay then. I'm far enough away from the star where hopefully I can scan those other two. This joystick is really quite old now, and it's been stored in basically the same room that my dogs come in dirty into.
Cannot comply. Cannot comply. Frameshift drive charging.
So it's dirty and dusty. And it drifts really slowly if I don't add a dead zone. Lots of rings in this system. I'm just gonna get going, otherwise I'm not gonna make my the bookmark that I intended to get to by the end of the stream.
Warning, frameshift drive operating beyond safety limits.
Thank you.
Frameshift drive charging.
Hopefully this isn't a run of brown dwarfs coming up. Trainer, really appreciate you hosting. That's actually the first time that anybody has actually hosted me. Thank you very much.
Frameshift drive charging.
I assume you were streaming Elite. So you've only just purchased it.
Frameshift drive charging.
11 jumps to go. I was a similar way. I actually had alpha access because I backed it on the Kickstarter, and then I kind of fell out of love with the game pretty much in 2016, and then didn't play again until this year. And I feel like enough has changed where, you know, I feel a lot more positive about it, really. Or maybe I've changed. to the point where, you know, I can kind of deal with its faults a little bit better. But yeah, I think starting with exploration, it's a little bit easier for me because I, you know, it's kind of more of a chilled out experience. But I think once I'm done with this exploration run, I think I'll find a lot of the regular gameplay a lot more fun as well than I used to. It was around the point that the engineers were implemented that I kind of got a little bit burned out on it. I don't really know what it is about exploration that even when I was totally burned out on the whole rest of the game, I still could go exploring. So, yeah. Yeah, I really like this scan system. I feel like that's a pretty big quality of life improvement for me personally.
Surface scan complete.
What's interesting about it too is that I thought having tried to research the scan system before I started playing again, I actually thought that the scanning system would be slower. But I feel like now it's actually a little bit faster, obviously, to scan a system where you can sit there and get all of the planetary bodies rather than flying to them. But also what I'm finding is that systems that I previously would have just, you know, moved through without doing anything, I now get curious about because of the scan results. And like I just before you came in, I found a water giant. Like, it wasn't labeled as a gas giant, it was labeled as a water giant. And they've probably existed in the game for a long time. It's just that I probably didn't scan enough of what I thought looked like gas giants to see them. You know, so it's... The actual scan result got me interested because it was right next to where the water world result would be, but it wasn't quite in that area. So yeah, I think they've actually done a really good thing with this scan system. Enjoy your lunch. Thank you for the host and for the follow. I really do appreciate it. Enjoy the rest of your day. really close. Bookmark that I'm heading to, it's I think it was mentioned on the Distant Worlds 2 thread, and it's basically a planetary nebula or a single system nebula. And I try not to spoil things for myself too much, so I haven't read whether there's any kind of white holes or anything like that within the system. So, yeah. That's where I'm heading towards. Got sidetracked a few times today. A couple of different locations. Of geological sites, biological site, which was the first time that I saw, I think they were called brain trees. So, yeah, it's all new stuff to me. Feel like I have to check that FSS, even when it says that I scan the whole system. I feel like if I don't, I'll miss something. Directly in front, that might be the nebula that I'm heading to. I'm not 100% sure it would be possible to see it at this point. Two jumps. And it's a black hole. Okay.
Frameshift drive charging.
Close to this star. Very, very close. Yeah. 6.67. It's not landable. But it might be cool to get close to it. Screenshot. shot. That's where I'm flying. So if you're watching and you're wondering what the hell I'm doing, I am editing together a video of this trip, and every so often I'll just stop and get some footage of stuff like this. The little nebula that I'm heading to.
Frameshift drive charging.
That's the next jump. Okay, so there's one jump right next to it. Okay.
Frameshift drive charging.
Thank you. So this next system was my kind of intended destination for this stream, so you're pleased to have made it. And like I just said, just gonna get like 10 seconds of video footage. Which is being recorded on a separate capture card at full resolution. System fully scanned. A long way to the secondary star. And nothing's landable. See how close. Whoa. Tiny black hole. We'll have it selected, right? But it's, it is there. Sure how close I can get. I'll find out. Okay. to move in the ship, to move the camera, slight bit of rotation. Oops, too fast. Moving the ship back a little bit because I'm probably very close to the exclusion zone. So if I fly forward right now so I can do like a flyby, it'll actually bounce off. Heat sinks are working overdrive right now. That's actually pretty cool. Love the lensing effect. Anyway, that is that. So my kids are probably going to be up anytime now. How far am I away from Seoul? Just 12,500 light years. Edit this because I've been to it now. Okay, so I have one more bookmark that I basically stole from the Distant Worlds 2 thread. And once I'm done with that, then I'm gonna make my way probably through all of these nebulas here towards Sagittarius A. And then once I'm done with that, I'm going to head up to Beagle Point. Now, these bookmarks here are ones that I've never been to, just these here. I basically wanted to make sure that I'll be able to get through the void here, where there's less stars to use for jumping. But I'm not terribly sure that I'll actually take these three here. I may actually go out to one of the arms and then around. And see what happens. The other bookmarks here are places that I've actually been to in the past, in 2016 or before. And I quite like the changes that they've made to exploration. It's actually made it pretty interesting. So yeah, if you want to be notified when I stream in the future, please click follow. Thanks to Vang, who followed, Train, who followed and hosted, and I will try to... I'm going to try to set a kind of regular streaming schedule, I think, of about 4 a.m. my time. And then basically, if I get up at that time, I can either work or stream, depending on how work is going. Let's see what I've got here. I'm actually wanting to quickly look and see if anybody else is streaming Elite Dangerous that I can kind of push you guys to. Okay, he's actually hosting me. Oh. Sorry, I'm not used to doing this. Okay, so I think I'm gonna do Fiery Toad, I guess, who I've followed since about 2014. Do I raid him or host him? I'm not sure, I've never done this before. I think I'll just click host. So if it cuts me off, thanks very much everybody. There's been a cool stream because there's been people actually taking part in chat, which really improves things. It you know, makes it nicer to do this. So thank you for that, and be sure to click follow if you haven't already, and I will try to stream around this time on other days. Thanks. Bye-bye.